By the end of this tutorial, you'll have your own email server set up on a VPS with your own domain, mailboxes, webmail access, and full send and receive using just a few simple commands. To make sure everything works as shown, I strongly recommend using the same VPS I'm using. Not all providers are the same. Some block ports that are essential for email to work properly. The one I recommend is high spec, reliable, and one of the most affordable options out there. You'll find all the links and command lines in the description box below. Alright, without further delay, let's jump in. First, we'll start by getting the VPS we'll use for the email server. For this project, this plan with 3 vCPUs and 8 GB of RAM is powerful, and more than enough. Let's click Install VPS to begin. Let's switch this to monthly. And let's change the country to my country and set the currency to USD. For the storage type, I prefer NVMe. It's faster. We don't need extra space here. Speed is what matters. Let's keep all these configs as they are. And here, let's type a password we'll use to log into the VPS. This one's important. Make sure you remember it. Everything set on this page. Let's click Next. I'm already a customer, so I'll log in. If you're new, you can register instead. I don't need backup here, but if you do, you can activate it for a few extra dollars. It's quite affordable. Everything looks correct. My PayPal is already linked. Let's click Order and Pay. The payment is complete, and my VPS was delivered instantly because I'm an existing customer. If you're new, it might take 1 to 3 hours due to account verification. Let's now check the email for the login details. I received 3 emails, one confirming the order, one from PayPal, and another with the login details we need. Let's open the one with the login data. And here, all we need is the VPS IP address. Let's copy it and store it in a text editor for later use. Next, we need a software that lets us connect to our VPS. Let's type PuTTY, then click on the first result. Download PuTTY, and here, I'm going to choose the 64-bit version. Let's go ahead and install it. Nothing special here, just a standard installation. Let's select the option to add it to the desktop. Great, let's open it up. And here, I need to copy the VPS IP address into the hostname or IP address field. Let's give it a name. I'm going to call it Mail Server. And then click Save. That way, next time I open PuTTY, I can just load this session without having to re-enter everything. Let's click Open to connect. You'll see a warning. That's completely normal the first time you connect. Just click Accept. For the username, type root, and for the password, use the one you set during the purchase. Here it says System Restart Required. We can easily reboot the VPS by typing reboot and pressing enter. Now it's time to install a control panel. It'll make managing everything much easier. Let's go to Cloudflare and select the domain name we'll use. Click on DNS to manage the domain's DNS settings. Then click on Add a Record. Let's type panel as the name and point it to the IP address of our VPS. Let's reconnect to our VPS so we can install the panel. Let's first download the panel using this command. You can paste it by simply right-clicking your mouse. In this second command, make sure to add your domain name right after the dot, just like I'm doing here. Type Y and press Enter to remove the conflicting packages. Let's type Y and press Enter to continue with the installation. Here, we need to type a username and password that we'll use to log into the panel. Let's save them in the text editor so we can reuse them later. From this point on, the installation will take around 10 to 15 minutes. Just be patient. The installation is finished. Now let's copy our login details and paste them into the text editor. To connect to the panel, just copy the URL and paste it into your browser. Here we can log in using the credentials we created during the installation. Now, it's required to create a new user. You can choose any username and password you want. It's straightforward. To make sure I don't lose them, I'm going to store them in the text editor. Let's save and log in as the new user. Now we can click on Mail, enter our domain name, and then click Save. Let's click on the domain name, then add a new mail account. Let's call it admin and generate a password for it. I'll save these in the code editor so I can reuse them later. Let's go back to the domain name and click on DNS records. This will let us configure the necessary records for our email to work properly. We need to add each of these records one by one, and it's important to select the correct type for each. The first two are A records, which point to the VPS IP address. The third is an MX record with priority 10. It handles incoming email. The rest are TXT records, which help with email authentication and deliverability. Make sure to disable the Cloudflare proxy for the A records by clicking the orange cloud icon to turn it gray. If the proxy stays active, your email won't work properly because it will be hidden behind Cloudflare, and incoming messages may fail to reach your server. Now that we've finished entering the DNS records, there's one last step. In the domain list, click the yellow pencil icon to edit the domain. Then enable DKIM support, activate SSL, and select Use Let's Encrypt. Finally, click Save. Now just click on Open Webmail to access Roundcube and log in using the mail account credentials we created earlier. Now it's time to run a couple of tests. First, we'll check if sending emails works, and then we'll test receiving. And as you can see, the email we sent was delivered successfully. Now let's go to Gmail and try sending a message to our mail server to see if we can receive it and confirm that everything is working correctly. Let's refresh. It might take a bit of time for the message to arrive. And it worked. We've got our mail. Everything is up and running. Thanks for watching. If you found this helpful, feel free to subscribe for more tutorials. And if you have any questions or need help, just drop a comment below. I'll do my best to respond.